So if you've been following me a long time, you know I love pickles. And I make my own. But not just pickled cucumbers from my garden, but also pickled peppers. And over the summer, I have made a plethora of pickled peppers and cucumbers to try. Pickled peppercinis. A chamoy pickle with ghost pepper infusion. And your run-of-the-mill, like, bread and butter pickle, so let's get down to it and let's try these bad boys out, shall we?
That bread and butter? Right off the bat, just a perfect classic pickle.
Our smoky sandwich pickle.
We'll get that. Put this on here, Thor!
There we
go. Oh. It's almost got like a barbecue flavor profile. I put like a tiny bit of liquid smoke in there, just like the smallest amount, and it really brings that out. There's also a bunch of garlic in there as well. Superb.
Now for the one I've been waiting for, my peppercinis.
All right, we'll take one right off the top. Oh, look at that little guy. Grew these in my garden. So this is like a cup of sugar, some cherry vinegar, to give it a little bit more sweetness as well, and then a quarter cup regular vinegar, and then 2 cups garlic. So let's go at it. Mmm. You know what that tastes like? Tastes like the ones that they put in the Papa John's pizza. Except, you know, less racism.
Now this one is gonna be good.
So before I get to the chamoy pickle, the peppers, my ghost peppers, have a 90-day life cycle. So I've been waiting for these for quite some time.
Oh, look at that. Smells sweet and a little bit spicy.
Mmm. There's that heat. But is perfectly complemented by that sour and sweet flavor. Chef's kiss, 10 out of spicy 10. Ooh, a dog.